Greetings from the Redeemed Christian Church of God in Oklahoma City. This is the Open Heavens for April 23rd, 2020. Open Heavens is a daily devotional written by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. It's a great day to be alive. This is the day that the Lord has made, and you and I shall rejoice and be glad in it. And even as we go into the reading, into the study of His Word today, I pray that the Almighty God will bless us richly by this Word, and His Word will be deeply rooted in our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. The title for today is Joy Like a River. Joy Like a River. The memory verse is Proverbs chapter 15, verse 13. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 13 says, "A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, but by sorrow of the heart the spirit is broken. A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance." Psalm 51, verse 10 to 13 is the Bible reading. Psalm 51, verse 10 to verse 13 reads, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me by your generous spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall be converted to you." May God bless the reading of His holy words in Jesus' name. Amen. We are still going to come back to verse 12 and verse 13. You can see there that, you know, the 12 talks about restoring to me the joy of your salvation, which is in line with the topic of joy like a river. And verse 13 now talks about, "I will teach transgressors your way, and sinners will be converted to you," which shows that even through the joy of the Lord that we have, even as we're going to read it later in devotional, we can use that as an avenue to bring sinners into God's kingdom. And what is joy? It's a fruit, and a powerful fruit, of the Spirit. And that is the privilege that has been given to us as Christians, as believers, to experience all-round peace and joy. Now, Daddy starts the devotional today by clearly differentiating between happiness and joy. So what is happiness? Well, that is usually is triggered by happenings around one. It is circumstantial, based on circumstances or based on happenings. That is when one is joyful, which means a simple negative tone can spoil somebody's happiness or ruin it. But joy is not the case like that. Joy even flows through the times of trouble. It is not circumstantial. It's not based on happenings around. It's not based on situations. Joy flows on through all of this. Nothing is not dependent, even on earthly condition. Rather, joy is based on spiritual conviction, because it's a fruit of the Spirit. So nothing can hinder the flow of joy because of circumstances or situations. No, joy keeps flowing even through any particular circumstance or situation. And that is also teaching us here that joy, the perpetual joy, is also as a reward of obedience to the Word of God. So how can we link the Word of God to joy? The answer is found in Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 16. It says, "Thy words were found, thy words were found, and I did eat them. And thy word was unto me joy and rejoicing of my heart. So which means that joy is rooted in the word of God. Do you want to live in joy? Do you want to live in perpetual joy? Then the place of the word of God is very, very germane to us having joy. So if, and you know, when you, if you say, how do I get joy? How can I search for joy? You know, you cannot search for joy in the world. No, we have to search for joy in the word of God. Like we just read in Jeremiah 15, verse 16. The word of God is very, very essential for us to dwell in so that we can have joy. Now, going back to what we read in verse 12 and verse 13 of Psalm 51. The joy that we have in us as Christians should also propel us to preach to sinners so that they can be converted into his kingdom, to help the poor, to visit the widow, to help the fatherless. Of course, to preach the good news of God's kingdom, the joy that God gives unto us as we dwell in his word, as we obey his word, should propel us to do all these things. And you know, another important thing where we can use to measure the kind of joy we have is it beneficial to others or not? So the joy that we have should benefit others, should bless others, should infect others with the joy of God that we have in us. Because any other kind of joy that is just self, that is just meant to promote self or just to bless self, it's not, can't be from God, and it's not even worth it. So, and that it goes further again. You know, we have looked about a way to test the kind of joy we have. Another way our dad is teaching us today is that there are different, there are diverse kinds of joy. There's joy of one's own salvation, which of course we read in Psalm 51. The joy, restore to me the joy of my salvation. But there's also joy of salvation unto others, which we like. Well, that's why we said the joy that we have should be beneficial of to others. And even the joy, there should be joy in our hearts when others are saved and brought into God's kingdom. There should also be joy when we see young converts walking in truth. When you see that somebody that was not born again became born again and they are walking in line with the word of God, it should give us joy in the lives of such people. So, but the joy, like we mentioned, that joy should be beneficial to others first. In line with that too, the joy of salvation in others should surpass the joy of our own salvation. Seeing other people being saved, seeing other people being set free from the bondage of sin, that joy should even surpass the joy of our own salvation, because it's a blessed privilege even for us to be used to win souls into God's kingdom. Because when we win souls into God's kingdom, such people are delivered from sin, from sickness, from poverty, from bondage. And such a privilege is the eye of bringing others into God's kingdom by the joy that we have that we're extending to others, and by the help of the Holy Spirit, is a great and a high honor that anyone can receive. And that is praise for us, that I pray that the joy of the Lord will overflow in you, and you'll become a source of joy to the whole world in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So for us to get joy, we need to be deeply rooted in his word, and that joy has to impact others around it too, in Jesus' name. The prayer point: Father, please let joy like a river flow through me to the world in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, we pray, O God, help us to be deeply rooted in your word so that, Lord God Almighty, O God, we can have that continual and perpetual flow of joy. And Lord, let your joy flow like a river in us, O God, even to the world out there in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you tomorrow by God's grace.